I'm Derek Alden, and I work here in the Avnu Consortium of the UNH-IOL. I'm a grad student at UNH studying computer science, and I'm going to walk you through how to configure and then actually use our test tool Violet, which is used to test time-sensitive networking. Time-sensitive networking is used in many different areas, including professional audio and video, automotive spaces, and industrial spaces, and Violet tests the common protocols that underlie all of those use cases. So I'm going to walk you through how to set up Violet from a fresh installation. If you have just downloaded Violet, then you should have a zip file which you can extract into a folder that looks like this. Violet supports both Windows and Linux. I'll be running you through Windows, but the configuration for Linux is very similar. On Linux, you can use this Violet launcher to automatically launch Violet, and on Windows, you can use this open.bat launcher. One thing that you'll need to get is a license, either a demo license or a long-term license from Avnu, and I've just pre-prepared a license here and already dropped it in the appropriate folder so that we don't have to worry about that. So once you've extracted Violet to wherever you're going to keep it, go ahead and launch it in whatever manner is appropriate for your operating system. It'll take a moment to start up and it'll greet you with a screen like this. So by default, Violet starts into a blank mode, but it has a bunch of modes that it supports. Some of these options may be grayed out or unavailable depending on your license, and you can contact the UNH-IOL to get a license that covers the other modes if that's something you're interested in. We have it broken up by the use cases, and then if you need a specific test plan, we have more detailed specific modes in the test plans menu. I'll be doing an example with the professional audio and video mode, so we're just going to switch into that. The first time that you start the tool, you'll be prompted with a licensing dialog. This is just the license that you need to accept in order to use the tool. We also redistribute some licenses of other components that are part of the tool. You can either hit I accept, or if you don't want to be prompted again, accept when the license changes or at version upgrades, you can hit accept, do not show again. Once you've done that, you'll see the mode that you've just switched into. In particular, if you chose one of the composite modes, you'll see a number of different expandable test tree items for different test plans that are part of that mode. Then I should also point out that all of these output panes and so on that I'm going to show you, they're actually configurable. So for example, if I were to open a widget, which I'll get to in a moment, you can actually drag these things around and configure how Violet looks, move things into different panels, and then you can go up to Window and then save Window Layout, and Violet will open by default in that layout. So with that out of the way, let's talk about how to actually configure Violet. There are a few tool settings that we should be configuring first. Most importantly, you want to specify what your username is, because Violet produces test artifacts, logs that can be used to attest that the test was run at a specific time in a specific way. And so having an accurate log of who's doing testing is important for that. You can also configure where Violet will store those log files and where it will store the capture files that it makes during tests. Additionally, if you want to leverage our Wireshark integration, you can select the location of your Wireshark installation, which on Windows is usually under C, Program Files, Wireshark, Wireshark, and on Linux is usually in User, Bin, Wireshark. Once you've selected your Wireshark installation location, set your username, you can look at some of these additional settings down below. Most of these are not particularly important, but they can be useful if you want to be made aware of specific things. Like, for example, we have the update settings that can automatically notify you when a new release of Violet is made. And we also have some accessibility settings like disable text color, which will completely disable coloration in Violet's output to make it easier to read for people who have color-based vision impairments. Additionally, you can set Violet to run each test a certain number of times. For example, if you want to determine whether or not some behavior of your device is flaky or sensitive to the environment, you can set Violet to run the test some large number of times and then leave it to run overnight. Once you've set all of these settings, you can go ahead and flip over to the device under test pane, where you can enter the details of exactly what it is that you're going to be testing. Since we're not hooked up to a real device right now, I'll just leave these blank, but by filling in this information, the captures that Violet generates and the logs that Violet generates will include this information, so again, you can use it as a testing artifact. I'll also mention that Violet supports a REST API that you can use to control Violet. More detail about that can be found in our user documentation or by starting the REST API and then going to its homepage, because all of the API commands should be discoverable. So once you've configured all of these settings to your liking, you can go ahead and hit Apply Changes, and that will save your configuration. Now let's talk about actually configuring your test stations. So Violet supports many different kinds of test stations. In particular, we support JPCAP test stations, which can be any ordinary NIC, but that don't allow some of the tests that involve more precise timestamping to be run in any of our supported OSs. So no matter whether you're in Windows or in Linux, you can always create a JPCAP test station. And that will just ask you to select a particular interface that's currently configured for your computer, and then give it a name that you can use to refer to it within Violet. You can also set the custom ingress and egress delays if you know them for the card, but if the card doesn't support hardware timestamping, then that won't help much. On the other hand, if you do want to do those tests that require precise timestamping, in Windows you can make use of our Echo test stations. Echo test stations use Echo Streamware NICs, and you can again select them and specify a local NIC name. Violet will also display your version of the various drivers, and you need to make sure that that is one of our supported versions. You can find more information on that in the user documentation. On the other hand, in Linux, in order to use hardware timestamping, you'll need to make use of either a device that supports the Linux hardware timestamping interface generically, or of a Intel i210, which also has some streaming capabilities. Some tests, particularly FQTSS tests, also require traffic generation, which can be done using our Ixia traffic generator integration. This licensing option costs extra, but you can reach out to the UNH IOL in the case that you already own an Ixia traffic generator for additional support and to get a copy of our Ixia configurations. I won't go into any more detail there, but know that it's an option that's available to you. Once you've got your test stations set up the way that you want them, you can then begin configuring the actual test mode that you want to do. So for example, if I wanted to do GPTP testing, I would open the GPTP config and set my test stations. So here, for example, I've said that I'm going to use the one that I called example for test station 1 and the one that I called EE for test station 2. You'll note that there are also a number of mode-specific settings here. You'll want to specifically set the MAC addresses that the DUT uses on the ports that you've connected to your test stations, because that's how Violet can actually identify the device that it is connected to. And you'll also want to set some GPTP-specific options. For example, the claim time source value and the whether or not the priority one can be modified. Those will change the requirements of tests in a way that matches up with the test plan. Additionally, we have some support for testing bridges with different number of streams supported, etc. If you're testing a Milan device, all of that is spelled out in the Milan standard, but if you're testing a non-Milan device, we support the ability to configure exactly how many streams you support, both globally and per port, so we can test your device no matter what its capabilities are. Once you've got your mode configured, you're going to hit Apply Changes, just the same, and then you're really ready to go. Now you can start using Violet. So I'm just going to run a GPTP test using this Start Test button, and you'll see it goes and runs, and Violet actually detected that we're connected to a device with a different MAC address than what we specified in the configuration. So we can quickly go back and update that configuration to match the MAC address of the device that we're actually testing. And once we've done that, Violet should provide valid results for this test. One thing to bear in mind is that some tests may have manual steps which you need to take while you're doing the testing. For example, many of the GPTP tests actually require you to change cables connected to different ports of the device, and Violet has an option which will allow you to skip the tests that require manual intervention. You'll find that under the configuration as skip manual tests, which is very useful for automatic testing or testing that you're performing overnight. You can see while I was talking that Violet ran through the test and determined that the device that I'm connected to doesn't pass this particular test. Violet can render a number of different kinds of results. So for example, Violet will give basic pass-fail information, but it'll also automatically observe and report informative arbiter points from the test plan where it's able to. Additionally, it can issue warnings in accordance with the test plan as well. All of that information can be reviewed, even for past runs, by going to the results viewer and then selecting the test that you're interested in. There you can see every run that Violet knows about, along with its result, its log, what the tool configuration was at the time, and any user editable annotations that you want to add to the result to explain your setup or why the result is or is not valid. If you want to review results from past sessions, you can also hit the log viewer button, which will do much the same thing, but will go back through all of the logs that Violet is aware of and present the same information. I mentioned earlier that I was going to talk about widgets, and now is probably a good time to do that. Widgets are little non-test bits of functionality that Violet packages to make it easy for you to test some more esoteric setups or test things manually. For example, we have this PTP Mass Report emulator widget, which allows you to simulate a PTP Grandmaster with or without BMCA on any given port, and that allows you to replicate problems if, for example, you're testing an automotive device that's not supposed to react to 2 ounces. This could be one way to do that. There is a specific test for that, but if you wanted to have, you know, more flexibility in the test setup that you were configuring. I should also mention we have the Sniffers widget, which uses our Wireshark integration to open a capture showing what's actually happening on the port according to Violet at that time. And this view is nice because it will also include injected Violet log messages. So if you go and look at the output for any one of the tests, you'll see that there's a link to where Violet has saved the captures. And if you open that, it'll open in Wireshark. Some of those packets, however, are going to have this protocol, and they'll actually be copies of the log message that you observed during the test. And that's particularly nice because it means that you can actually line up the steps of the test with what was actually happening on the wire when Violet claimed to observe something. Thank you so much for watching, and remember that you can find more information on our website at iol.unh.edu. Look for the time-sensitive networking section, and please go ahead and purchase Violet or try a demo.